My project with no name is related to the photographic series I did in 2000, between 2005 and 2008, and also some videos. I have some videos. So it was questioning the history by the landscape I took actually on the ex-concentration camp in France. During the Second World War, and the topic was related to the Roma, Sinti and Roma concentrated in this camp. So at the moment, in 2005, was not so common and was still a taboo for the to talk about this situation of the gypsies in France. And I decided to after to know about my grandfather was in the camp also with my grandfather. I decided to question the landscape more than the people. So it's related to the visible and invisible of of history in the contemporary photography. That also was aesthetic. We use also like actually in photography, the documentary photography. So it means like I met other photographs in the road, not in the road, but more in Europe, like in Ireland and Switzerland, that also they question the landscape to explain what's its visible and invisible, how the society and the politic trait now this topic. So it's really related to the to place this this topic in the geo-historical and geo-political context. Really, so that's was really my point of view and my way how I use and question this history. I start this photographic project regarding the history of my family's from my father's part. So they were concentrated in the camp. I discovered that in the archives. I questioned also the historian and sociology because I didn't have any answer of my question when I was a teenager. I questioned my grandfather about his stories and about the parents and the grandparents, etc. And it was always like I didn't really want to answer. So I decided to discover by myself the where it's from, where he was from, etc. And so I decided to do this project because actually it was also a generality in the Roma peoples in France that they didn't want to talk about that. Actually, with these works, I want to have a new narrative and a new discussion of related to the history of Second World War because it was a taboo and also this is the way how it was talked about this situation because and generally it's like a black and white photography of people so and the testimonies on close to them on the exhibition for example was not also made by the Roma with a Roma background. I didn't say here that if you are a Roma you can talk better than the other but I say since when it's happened it's still the same narrative, it's still the same discussion. So it's to give a new point of view and to also to leave the people to the audience when they see the photographs, they can imagine by themselves what happened there. It's not spectacular photography, it's the inverse. It's more like I don't know the word in English, it's forclusion. La forclusion de l'histoire means the hidden of history, the landscape hide hidden, was hidden the history. My process to discover this exhaustive site was with to work with the researchers also, that they did already some works about the concentration concentration camp of Roma. So I'm thinking about Pechensky and also Fiol, etc. And but the first step was with an institution that I know the director from there, that they asked them to research for me on the departmental archive if they find some files of my grandfather. And follow this this first step, I discover so many papers about them that. Also the anthropometric booklet that is exhibited in actually in the exhibition, and also other paper like the refugees card of my grandfather, where he was in the camp in France, in the close to where he was living at the moment, was at 10 kilometers where he was living, between my was strange because it was between this camp was settled between where my parents were living and my grandfather also. So when my grandfather visiting us, they was always pass through this this small village, the Jargeau. This camp became a secondary school. So it means like for the teenager are in the college, in the secondary school, they don't know how to deal with that, and also they don't know on what they walk on. You know, that's the way I think the French society decided, and the French politic decided to continue to live with this taboo in this certain way. You know, that's so I'm sure that for my grandfather and for the rest of the population in France, they didn't have the possibility to talk about, because if we compare to the testimony of Raymond Guérême, of other from France, they always say when they wanted to have a compensation or something like that, the French and the police say, it's better for you if you don't talk about that. It's better for your family. Because maybe the history can come back, and it's never stopped. That's the, yeah. The idea is to show that a camp could be everything. From everything, from a place, a private space, or a camp, or was actually a cinema. There was one close to here. Was a cinema. It became a camp, transit camp, and after a private house. So, and for each camp, they kept the same size. And but the function of the site changed. So I was more and more interested in this. How we build the camp? What is the camp actually? The law change in each camp. That's I did some interview that I focused the interview on what is the camp, how they manage a camp inside, and for each camp there was their own laws. That's the point. So. So also this landscape helped me to add this point of view in my questions, in my in the way that I wanted to talk about that too. It means like so I think there is more than 30 camps, but is it the real question? I'm not sure that it's important. It's of course this the number is really impressive when you think that 40 years ago we didn't talk about that. Means like you know, so for Roma, it's just like it's a lot. It's really a lot, and the generations need to know, needs to know today. What I want to say with this project and with also the with this series, it means like it's photography. The medium also should be questioned inside inside the project, because photography, you can say everything, the good way and the bad way, and you know, you can deal with photography. That's it's not like a weapon, but it could be like used like a weapon, you know, because you can give a stereotype, whatever you want with photography. That's the so I question also the medium inside this project. That's why I didn't want to. I took a photograph of people, but I didn't. As again I said, I didn't want to give them the testimony. We have enough about that. We have a lot about that. And so this is inside, and for me it's like I don't want to see a stone, a commemoration stone of each camp. That's not the. I don't think it helps all. I found this is like to put a stone and you don't do anything after that. It's no, it's that doesn't give also another possibility to change the narrative. For me, that's the photograph are more like a commemoration place. Kind of like by images, yes. Yes, of course, is one of the most of my project, but it means also was the beginning of a new way I talk about a certain subject with photography. Means like was the first time that I questioned the place, the traces and non-traces of the places. Related also to the landscape, related to the specific site, historical specific site that we call it also realms of memory, lieu de mémoire, from Nora, and so I think yes, all is related from this question of realms of memory, memory of the landscape, memory historical, memory. That's the paradigm, you know, memory or history or it's without to use this intimate. Family, history, or whatever. I'm not in this kind of things. I want to do something more general with this politic first point. Actually, this project is related to the past of part of my family. It's the only one. After that, I say it was the first project where I changed completely. Between a reportage and documentary photography and conceptual. Means I question the landscape, I question the site, the places, etc. So I continue in this way still now. Also with another project I did called In the Making was with about the emblematic places at Lichtenberg and also Friedrichshain, but more at Lichtenberg about the Stasi, that it's become a museum. So I mean also this kind of place become another function. So that's question also myself, like how you can do ex-ministry of Stasi become a museum and also a prison, a Riemann prison become a museum. Well, I found so, because of course they want to keep, I think the idea is to keep the objective objective speech, objective Christian, objective, but you you can't actually, because it's not in the moment. So yeah, how to deal? We are all in the same question. It's to question how we keep history, how we can deal with history by testimony, by text, by photography, by videos. Yeah, that's so yeah. Of course, it's one of my most important project, but it's not the only one. I did it in 2005, so now I'm 16 years later. I'm in other things, but still, it's always the same question. It's talking about the past. So yeah, I'm continue and I'm going still continue on the place where the past can be visible or invisible. It's always the same. Yeah. About the emotion of this site, about how I was feeling on the site, it's not regarding the phantoms or the invisible also, but it's more like analytic. It's more clinical, I think, minimalist. So it means like I want to be the more neutral I can, but it's never possible as an artist, I think. But I don't want to be in one point or other point. It's I like to be in the middle. I need to be a Christian also by the audience. I need the audience for this photograph. Without the audience, I'm nothing.